is News on the Lane. Good morning, I'm Lily B.
And I'm Phoebe Kett, reporting from the remote Rosemary Angelina Broadcast Center.
Today is Monday, May 17th, 2021. It is day 5 of the 12-day cycle.
Our Pledge of Allegiance will be led by some Indian Lane students. Please stand, face the flag in your classroom, and put your right hand over the heart to recite the pledge.
Please remain standing for a moment of silence.
Please join us in reciting the Bobcat Pledge, led by some of your teachers.
We pledge to be ready, respectful, and responsible.
Offer a helping hand.
Be a friend to everyone.
Care about feelings.
Accept differences.
Tell an adult.
Stand up for what is right.
Please be seated for some news and announcements. Today, the big story on the lane is that students will begin recording their poems for their class's virtual poetry cafe today in library class.
Today in library class, the following classes will share their poems with an audience of their classmates. Mrs. Shuck's 5th grade class, Mrs. Johnson's 4th grade class, Mrs. Ford's 2nd grade class, Mrs. Novello's 3rd grade class, and Mrs. Miley's 1st grade virtual students.
We have some birthdays to announce for this week. Take a look.
Happy birthday, everyone.
Today, the main lunch is... The alternate lunch choice is a yummy sandwich or PB&J.
Remember to make healthy food choices for lunch and snacks throughout the day. A good snack choice could be a fruit cup.
There is no school for students tomorrow due to Election Day. You may be wondering why there's another election day.
The election tomorrow is a primary election, also known as the primaries. In this type of election, registered voters can vote for their preferred candidate within their political party.
The two major political parties in America are the Republican Party and the Democratic Party.
So basically, no one is actually elected in a primary election. But the Republican and Democratic candidates with the most votes moves on to the general election next November.
Crash, you hear something break. Uh-oh, a vase shattered. Pieces on the floor, what a shame. Your mom sees it and blames you. Your brother says, I saw you do it. And pointing at me, the innocent one, Mom believed him and now I'm doing his chores and cleaning up the vase.
Fireworks in the night sky, mostly seen on the 4th of July. On special days, happy ones too. I see them on birthdays. How about you?
You read home to get smarter. Flip the page. What do you see? A lot of words looking at me. Fiction is my favorite. Free to just read.
And I'm in 3rd grade. I'm reading a poem that I made called Tulips. Tulips are red, yellow, pink, but never blue. Tulips are different colors like me and you.
Hi, my name's Lily, and I'm reading homework too. I cook my math book in a broth and stirred it to a steaming froth. I threw in papers, pencils too, to make a pot of homework too. I turned the flame up nice and hot and tossed my binder in the pot. I sprinkled in my book report with colored markers by the court. Despite its putrid, noxious gas, I proudly took my student class. And though the smell was quite grotesque, I set it on my teacher's desk. My teacher said, "You're quite a chef, but still, you're going to get an F." I didn't ask for homework stew. I said, "Tomorrow, homework stew."
Remember to be ready, respectful, and responsible each day. When your teachers notice your bobcat behavior, you may earn bobcat pride.
And when we earn enough brides again, we will have another fun reinforcer.
Students who will record their virtual poetry cafe on Wednesday should practice their poems and come prepared.
These classes are Dr. Davis's fifth grade class, Ms. Cantalosi's in-person fourth grade students, Ms. Ferdon's second grade class, Mrs. Herman's third grade class, and Ms. Parkinson's first grade class.
There's a virtual PTG meeting on Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Registration for Run the Lane is now open. Families choose either in-person race on Saturday, June 5th, or the virtual race. Check it out on the website.
Showing you how to make edible cookie dough. What you're going to need is measuring spoons, more measuring spoons, a whisk, something of 4 ounces of applesauce, 2 sticks or a cup of butter, baking soda, baking powder, sugar, and flour. You're gonna get a bowl, and in your bowl, you're gonna put 2 3/4 cups of flour. I'll be back when I have that.
Next, you wanna put a teaspoon of baking soda,
and you whisk all that together and set it aside.
Now you either can leave these out all day to soften, but since I didn't do that, I'm gonna warm up 1 cup of butter or 2 sticks in the microwave.
It should be good, but see if it needs more.
KitchenAid or mixer. So after these been warmed up for 15 seconds, put it into a large bowl.
Add in 1.5 cups of sugar.
Bring that together until smooth.
Using the paddle attachment, you're using a kitchen aid.
Together, it should look something like that.
You're going to want to add 1 teaspoon of vanilla and your applesauce. If you want to bake these and you want them to turn out really good, I would recommend using eggs instead of applesauce. If you want to use eggs, it's 1 egg in all your applesauce. And mix that until smooth.
And you want to pour in your dry ingredients that you set aside earlier, little by little, until smooth.
Start to form dough.
Scrape the sides to get all of it.
Looks something like this.
There's your edible cookie dough.
You can also bake this. And just store it. Just put it into a Ziploc bag and put it in the fridge.
And eat it in a little glass dish and a spoon. Enjoy.
For all crew members and special reporters, I'm Lily B.
And I'm Phoebe K. Have a marvelously magnificent Monday.